defining a good product or a good service is a continuous work, a continuous process, a continuous aim in the startup or the company's life. You have to evolve, you have to understand the consumer's needs, the expectations. So whatever claim you are making, if you are able to achieve or overachieve that claim, that's a great product or a great service. It can be as mundane as a haircut. If a barber says that, yes, I'm going to give you a clean, neat shave or a haircut, and he does that without spending too much time, without doing too much dramatics or tricks, it's a great service. In technology or in business or in a complex product, let us say a vaccine or a health related or even manufacturing or agriculture, whatever you are delivering to the customer, the claim has to be absolutely on the spot. The solution has to be absolutely on the spot. You cannot claim the moon and deliver the gutter to the customer. So I think a good product or service identifies the customer needs, spoken as well as unspoken. So there are a lot of times customers will say, okay, I don't want this, okay. However, he may be delighted if he gets that kind of product or service, okay. It could be the very basic needs of the customer. It could be really latent needs. It could be something lifestyle related, luxury related. It could be something which is maybe he wants to show off. So a lot of products and services are not there for the very basic needs, but for some other level of needs of the customer. Okay, so I think getting the right product or the right service, also price is very important. Okay, you can't say that yes, BMW is a great product but Maruti 800 is a bad product. No, there are two different products. Each of them has got their core benefit, each of them has got their core service which they are offering to the customer. So I think the combination of the price, the delivery, the expectations, the claim, the promise, and then finally the customer's expectations being met, that makes a great product.